Let's say we're asked to find the slope of a line between negative 4, 3 and the point 2, negative 9. Let's say we assign the first point to be negative 4, 3, so we assign those coordinates x1, y1, and we assign 2, negative 9 to be the second point, x2, y2. Hopefully you remember that the slope is always given by rise over run, but it can also be represented as a change in y over a change in x. And this is where the formal formula comes from. y2 minus y1 is essentially just a change in y, or in a formal way of talking about the rise. The quantity x2 minus x1 is just a change in x, and it's also a formal way of talking about the run. So if we plug in the numbers where they belong, y2 is negative 9, so we place that here. y1 is 3, so we place that here. Notice it is y2 minus y1. We do the same thing with the denominator. x2 is given as 2, but x1 is given as negative 4. Now please make sure you avoid this mistake. Students often will replace this negative with this one. It's x2 minus x1. If the x1 quantity itself is negative, that's perfectly fine. Just place it within parentheses. That way you don't make a mistake. Now if we distribute the negative times a negative will give a positive, and 2 plus 4 will give us a 6. Negative 9 minus 3 yields negative 12. And if we reduce this fraction, we get that our slope is negative 2.